These days, a lot of tools come out and claim to be AI powered, and I do my best to test as many as possible. But what I find a lot of the times is that these are tools that are not that useful, just remarketed with the AI buzzword on top now. So in today's video, I'll be showing you AI powered tools that are actually useful. How would I know? Because I use all of these regularly. None of these are sponsored. I'm simply showing you what I actually find useful, but your time is valuable. So let's get right into it. And I'll actually demo them too, because that's simply the best way to show these off. Let's go. Tool number one, UberDuck. So as per usual, I'll link all of these in the description. But what this does is generate text to speech, meaning you can input text and one of the voices is gonna read it. Why this one is particularly interesting is because it has been trained on a lot of relevant voices. So we could, for example, simulate Geralt of Rivia from Witcher here. Let's try it out.
That is the last time you steal my voice.
All right, let's do someone else. How about Morty here?
Oh, jeez. Come on, Iker. Let's show off some use cases for this.
All right, Morty. So one thing you can do is use it for your content creation, just like I'm doing now. And I do plan on using this more and more in the future. I think it's such a cool feature to have some of these popular characters pop up in your videos, especially for short form videos. This is pure gold because you can hook the people with a popular voice, right? How does the copyright around this shake out? Honestly, I don't know. And I haven't been able to find any good resources around this on the internet. So if you have an idea, leave a comment below. But for now, I'll be using Morty as my co-pilot for this video. And that is that. But before we move on, let's talk about more use cases for this, because you could take rappers' voices and generate fake songs. Now, if you go over to YouTube and take a copyright-free beat in that artist's style, you have a brand new song that you just wrote. And if you stack ChatGPT on top of that, you all of a sudden have a recipe for how to create custom songs by popular artists. Again, not sure how this is gonna play out on the copyright front, just something to be aware of. And honestly, up until now, personally, I have been coming back to this as a form of entertainment. Trust me, when you're with some people and you whip out a sentence by Morty here and let him repeat a signature statement that maybe comes up a lot.
Hit the like button, like now.
This is guaranteed to make everyone's day better. Moving on, upscaler.media. This super simple app does one thing, but it does it really well. Upscaling images. Now, why is this useful? Let me show you an example where I actually use this. So if you go to my website, the homepage has this matrix style character in the front and he looks something like this. But this was the original output from Midjourney, all right? So this is what I got, and all I did is retouch a few details with Photoshop. But this picture doesn't have enough of a resolution to put it as the background of your homepage. It looked terrible because if I scale it up, it looked somewhat like this. And after simply uploading it to the tool, this is what I got. Jesus Christ, can we get that again? Look. Before, after, before, after. And this thing is free, isn't that amazing? So essentially every time you finish a picture on Midjourney, you can go in here, upload it, and it 4x's the quality of the image. Now you can go ahead and print it, use it as a background for your website, and it's gonna hold up for a lot of use cases where previously the output was simply not large enough. Simple yet extremely powerful. This is another one that is fantastic to try with your friends, because this app allows you to talk to famous characters. So let's just pick Socrates here, a legendary Greek philosopher. And now you can talk to him because this language model has been trained on his writing. So let's just say, hey there. Why, hello. Would you like to help us find out how much truth is in the statement that beauty and goodness are in the same thing?
Oh man, that's deep.
Okay, Socrates does not like small talk. Do you think beauty and goodness are in the same thing? Well, there's only one answer to that. When I look into your eyes, I'm certain they are. Are we having a Tinder conversation with a Greek philosopher right now? If my eyes are they beautiful because they are good? Or are they good because they're beautiful? Well, as you can see, this can keep going, and from experience, I can tell you, he's really good at answering hard questions in his very own tone. And when you're weighing what to do on a big decision, actually consulting Socrates might not be the worst idea. And again, this might seem nothing but fun on the surface, but when you start using it with people or for content creation, you could turn this into a real goldmine when you cleverly plan out a series of shorts around this.
Show me something useful to almost everybody.
All right, Morty, if you say so, it's time to explore one of my favorites here. So there's many alternatives to this, but the one I use is called Glasp, and what it does is summarize YouTube videos. Let me show you. So you simply install the extension, and once you go to YouTube, you can go to any video, and at the top, a new box appears. And here you can see a written transcript of the video, okay? And once we have ChatGPT open, all you need to do is click this button, View AI Summary, and it's gonna write the prompt and copy the entire transcript for you. And in like 15 seconds, I have a written summary of this entire 8-minute YouTube video. And look at me just going to a 1.5-hour-long podcast packed with information, hitting this one button, and getting a comprehensive summary of everything. Are you serious? But here's what I learned from experience. The longer the video, the less valuable the summary.
Not great, not terrible.
After listening to this whole thing, this absolutely does not do it justice. It's packed with information and it feels like every sentence is valuable in there. So for that type of content, a summary is not the best approach. But for a lot of casual conversations where you might care about one topic in there, this tool is your friend. And again, it's completely free. And the best part about these tools is there's so many of them and new ones keep popping up every day. But how do you keep up to date with that? Well, luckily I have a weekly newsletter where every week I feature one of these tools. Matter of fact, some of the apps in this video have been featured in previous newsletters. So go sign up for free and get amazing apps like this into your inbox once a week for free. And if you want to really level up your knowledge of AI, you'll want to check out this video because it shows you how to get more out of ChatGPT than most people.